Hi, this is Hannah from Tech Advisor, and today we are unboxing the Oppo Reno 8 Pro, which has made its debut in the UK and Europe. It's one of three phones in the Reno 8 line, joined by the standard Reno 8 and the more affordable Reno 8 Lite. Now, this phone comes with a sleek design, ultra-fast charging, and alleged really good night mode capabilities on the camera. But what else does it have to offer? So you might be thinking, the Reno 8 line, haven't I heard that before? And yes, you probably have, especially if you live in China or India, because these phones launched all in China all the way back in spring, I think, and then in India a little bit later. And there have been versions of Reno 8 that are essentially like repackaged Reno 7 phones. That have launched in other countries such as like Indonesia and Thailand, but they are exclusively new to the European market. So here it is. Now, we don't have official UK or European pricing or a release date at the time of filming. However, you can click through to techadvisor.com and we should have that information available on our website by the time this video goes up, so you can find out all about that. But this is a mid-range phone, and yeah, it's a pretty nice looking phone. And that's no surprise for Oppo phones in general. I always love their designs and what they do. I will chat a little bit more about the design in a second. Let me go through and rummage through this box and see what's in there. So we just have some packaging, the 80 watt Super VOOC charger, which if you like your fast charging, you will certainly get it with the Reno 8 Pro. And we have the cable in there as well. And I think that's basically everything that's in this phone. Yeah, I don't want to break it. But yeah, it's the cable there. Now, some of you may notice that we don't have a case in the box, I don't think. Let me just double check and see if there is one in here. I think this is just going to be, yeah, we've got your pin, quick guide, safety guide, another safety guide, and an adapter there. But yes, no case in the box from Oppo. We did get clarification on that. It's to do with just essentially reducing the amount of packaging and for environmental reasons. But if you are a clumsy clogs like myself, just be aware that there is not one included in the box. So here it is. It comes with this sort of flat edge design, nice and curved, feels nice to hold in the hand, pretty lightweight. And this sort of quite big striking camera module on the back here. So I have the black variant, which I think is called Glaze Black. But if you like a bit of color, you can also get it in a really nice sort of pastel green. I'm a bit sad I haven't got that variant. I do love a pastel phone myself, but there you go. So on the front, you have a 6.7 inch AMOLED display with 120 hertz refresh rate. And when we get into the phone, we'll be able to see more about the sort of capabilities on that. And it has support for HDR 10 plus. The bezels are allegedly the slimmest that has been on a Reno phone so far. And you have this sort of punch hole camera on the front there. It also comes with an IP54 rating. So that means it is protected against a little bit of dust particles and the odd splash, but don't think that you'll be able to use this in a pool or like in a desert and get it covered in sand, because you might end up with a little bit of damage on there. On the bottom, you have the USB-C slot. So that is for mainly your 80 watt Super VOOC charger. Now, if you're wondering how much juice that will give you, Oppo claims that apparently it will charge the phone to around 50% in 11 minutes. We haven't had the chance to actually test it out ourselves, but as charging speeds go, 80 watts is pretty good. The battery itself is a 4,500 milliamp hour battery. So it's pretty standard really in a phone of this size, nothing groundbreaking, but hopefully it should last you more than a day. Sadly, from what I can see here, no headphone jack. Becoming more and more standard these days. I'm trying to get used to using Bluetooth headphones, but I miss wired headphones, I have to say. So it is saying hello to me, so we may as well go and set this phone up. So I'll see you in a sec when I can set this all up. And we're back. So here we go. Here is the phone all set up and ready for you. Now then, let's have a look a bit about the device. So as we can see, the processor for this is a MediaTek Dimensity 8100 Max. And it comes with 8 GB of RAM and 256 GB worth of storage. So that is the only configuration that this phone comes in. In general, this should result in pretty fast performance, good for multitasking, maybe even some light gaming, though nothing heavy duty, obviously. If you're familiar with Oppo's sister brand, OnePlus, this phone should perform generally a bit like the OnePlus 10R because it has the same chip and a lot of other similar features, like Oxygen OS is quite similar to Color OS. So yeah, you should expect sort of similar performance from that if you follow those sorts of brands. Speaking of which, Color OS. So this runs on, it says Android 12, so this is Color OS 12.1, which is Oppo's skin of Android 12. And as Android skins go, this is a pretty clean one. As you can see, it's quite the apps are space, nice and lots of space there, and lots of good quick features for everything that you need. And I, in general, as somebody who uses a lot of pure Android and stock Android, I find Oppo skin to be probably one of the better ones out there, like minimal app clutter from what you can see. A lot of the time you come with weird installed loads of different apps and stores that you're just never going to use, and Oppo thankfully isn't too guilty of that. So if you're thinking Android 12, what about Android 13? Well, ColorOS 13, which is Oppo's skin of Android 13, will be coming to the Oppo Reno phones, but it won't be coming probably until the end of this year / the beginning of next year. So you're in for a little bit of a wait for it. That OS comes with a slightly different design, more curved out edges, and features to do with digital well-being. We actually have a hands-on preview that I did with ColorOS 13, and you can check that out on techadvisor.com. Now then, we can see this big bright screen here that we've got, and we can have a quick look at the refresh rate a little bit more. So you can switch between high and standard, so that's 120 Hz for, as the phone puts it, smoother animations and operations, or 60 Hz, which is basically just to help conserve that battery life. So unfortunately, no variable refresh rate on the Reno 8 Pro. So we have a triple camera setup on the Reno 8 Pro. This is led by a 50 megapixel main lens and is joined by an 8 megapixel ultra wide and a 2 megapixel macro. And as you can see here, it is fitted with Mari Silicon X, and this is Oppo's dedicated MPU, the image processor. So it's helped to bring, basically, a lot of the things will be to do with low light, particularly low light videography. So if you're filming at night, it should be able to help brighten up those colors and help things appear much more vivid. And it can also help with things like if you're filming under bright sunlight and not having too much glare, helping colors appear more dynamic, those sorts of things. And this is the same MPU that is seen on the flagship Find X5 series. So it's a great bit of kit. And in general, you should probably expect some good things from the camera on the Reno 8 Pro. So there you have it. That is the Oppo Reno 8 Pro. I'm going to be spending some time with this phone to get more in depth and see what it exactly is capable of. So why don't you comment down below? Do you think that this is a flagship killer from Oppo? Let us know. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more unboxings and phone news from Tech Advisor. Thank you.